Hi everyone, so let's create a directory. Okay, here I will clone that repository. In the current working directory, so I will get the code. So here you can see I have a Docker file. So first let's take a look on Docker file. It is having the same from 7 working directory, copy package.json and all. So first we need to build the Docker file. Docker build minus t is the name, node app. Okay, this is the name, and Docker build minus t and dot. So it will pick the Docker file from the current working directory. Okay, invalid argument. You can see it was the name was incorrect. So it is running these instructions. It is first step one, it is getting the node from 7. Now it is pulling all the layers. So base image will be 1.2, on top of it, it will be installing the node.js, and it is giving us everything in hand. Okay, so it is very quick. It will take some time to extract all the files because we are pulling the Docker base image, and then we are installing the node just now. The other instruction, if you see what is happening here, we're getting some warnings. Downloading the newer image node 7 working directory. These are the instruction which we wrote, right? Now we have did the copy package.json, then we are doing run npm install, and finally copying the code to the F folder. It is running the node index.js and then exposing 8081 port, right? So this is what the basic thing we are prepared with, right? So we have, if you see Docker images, you will see node app somewhere. You can see the node app images there. So now if you Docker run minus p, we need to do the port mapping. What was the port? 8081 of host, 8081 of Docker. Docker run minus p, this is a port mapping, and you wanted to run node app, right? This is how we are running it. So app listening on port 8081. Now what I can do is new tab. Right, hello world, we got the response, right? So it means server is running and we got the application up and running, right? So this is how we can run the basic node.js code to a container, right? So we are getting the image for getting the applications like node.js, right, is MySQL, but we will be having the code in our local. We need to copy this code to our container to run it. So obviously we need to write a Docker file for each and every application, either it is a PHP, either it's a Java, either it's a Node.js app, because we will be writing some code, then we will be copying that code. If you see the Docker file, let me exit this. Command Z. Let me stop this container. So if you see Docker ps-a, this hello world node app container is now running. Either you need to pass the container ID, which I was expecting that it will give me the error. So it will try to stop the container. Docker stop container, because I already tried to forcefully exit it. Yeah, so because I'm able to exit because Docker container has been exited. Right, so if you check more Docker file, it is having these instructions, right? So obviously you will use some base image, you will write some code for the application, you will copy that code into the Docker container directory, right? And then you will run the Python app.py, node index.js, java index.java or something. Okay, this is how it is working. Thanks everyone. In next video, we'll talk more about the Docker.